Hey everybody, it's Perez and Jesse McCartney. You're actually dressed kind of warm. I am a little too, although it's like 80 something degrees in Los Angeles.
I'm comfortable. I'm used to it at this point, this weather.
I love it. I'm not complaining. I just wanted to dress like it was November for everybody else watching.
Right. You have to appear seasonal.
Yes.
Even though we're in California.
I know. I'm kind of melting in this, but I thought it would be cute. Now, you have a new album coming out?
Yeah.
What, is there a release date yet?
December 28th is the release of my...
December 28th?
Yeah.
That's like Christmas week.
It's right after Christmas week.
Whose idea was that?
It wasn't my idea, but it's a great idea.
It is?
Yeah.
Now, the first single is out already.
Shake.
Shake. Is it a sexy video?
I think you're going to like it.
Are you shirtless in it? Is there nudity?
There's no male nudity, but there's plenty of female. There's a lot of skin. It's going to be a good one.
I still remember that one video where you were like on the bed and stuff.
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah. Remember, you liked that one.
I did.
Yeah, it was one of the few positive remarks I had on Perez Hilton.
No. Now, you're still on Hollywood Records, right?
Still with Hollywood, yeah.
Do they give you, like, guidelines of what you can or cannot sing about or write
about?
No,
but I'm sure whoever the lyric people are that read... I remember they read they were reading the lyrics to my last album.
Because they're owned by Disney.
They're owned by Disney. So, but the thing is, I'm sort of in my own little space because they don't... I mean, I'm not going to rewrite my songs. That's not going to happen. But they were looking at my lyrics from
Did they censor them?
It's called... There was a song called In My Veins.
Yeah.
And it was sort of like the comparison of like... It was sort of a metaphor.
I want to be inside you?
It was sort of a drug...
I want you inside
it
me?
It was a drug metaphor. It was a drug metaphor for sex.
Okay.
Pretty much. And they were looking at it like, what is going on? Is he shooting heroin? Like, what is this? And I said, no, idiot. Read the lyrics further. Anyway. Hollywood's great. They've been my label for 7 years, and they've always been good to me, and they've let me kind of make the music I've wanted to make, and kind of been with me through the evolution, which started when I was 16, with Beautiful Soul. So it's been a wild ride. I don't want another pretty face. I don't want just anyone to hold. I don't want my love to go away. I want you when you're beautiful. So
are you like insanely popular in like one bizarre country? Like, are you really huge?
You know what's crazy is
where?
Taiwan.
Like, Taiwan?
I can't walk around in Taiwan without it. Like, it's like a presidential thing. Like, I walk in there, I get.
Why Taiwan?
I don't know. It's one of those spots. Like, it's one of those like you said, like one of those spots where you just show up and it's crazy.
Do you go there regularly? Like at least once a year?
I haven't been there in a couple years, but last time I was there, it was like literally they had like a butler in front of my hotel room. This like poor woman who was standing out front at like 3 a.m. I walked outside and I'm like, what are you still doing here? Like, I'm sleeping.
Now, everybody, well, all the ladies watching, I'm sure, want to know, are you dating anyone these days?
I'm not dating any, but, I mean, I've been dating.
Dating
but I'm not
plural?
Really, I'm not really dating regularly. I'm sort of a sporadic dater at this point.
What does that mean?
I mean, I've just been traveling so much that I don't really have time.
You can just take a girlfriend on the road with you. Have your makeup artist be your girlfriend.
That might be a little suffocating.
It would be?
Yeah.
You don't like that much time with a girl?
Not, I mean...
You like space?
On tour would even be worse. Like, she would get zero attention, zero time, because I'm constantly in work mode. The little time that I do have is maybe 4 or 5 hours to sleep in between.
She could sleep next to you.
My days.
That's quality time.
That's true. That's true. She doesn't mind the snoring.
You could date a dancer. No, but a dancer. Or a hair person.
I don't know.
No?
Eventually, that's another thing, another chapter of my life that's later in the book. But
the last girl you dated, was she, someone in the entertainment industry, or was she like a normal person?
The last girl that I dated actually was last night, and she's a normal person.
Oh my goodness.
She's not an industry girl.
How did you meet her?
I actually met her at a restaurant. I was sitting with a buddy and met her at a restaurant.
And you went up to her?
Huh? She was sitting next to us. And
then you just started talking?
We just started talking.
You asked her for her number?
Exactly.
Nice. Yeah.
I initiated the whole
thing. It gives hope to the ladies out there.
Yeah, I'll get your number. Just give me a window. Give me an opportunity.
Well, it has to be like clear, clear interest shown.
Oh yeah, there's got to be a clear signal.
Yeah.
It's got to be going on.
Yeah. And then you'll make that happen.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Jesse McCartney. I hope to see you all over America and Targets and Walmarts and Best Buys.
You will. You will very soon.
All right. Bye.
Ciao. I don't want just